today we're doing one very classic French dishes, bring back a bit with a bit of modernity, one of the classic to the restaurant, cod grenobroise. We're making two different options. We've got the one with the cod, or we're going to do the cauliflower later on.
What do we need to get done first? Is there anything that needs to be prepared in advance?
Yeah, then we ask to make sure you got your potatoes ready and cooked.
So you've specified the Ratte potatoes.
The Ratte's got a good waxiness to it, but easy to use. Yeah. And good flavor. Cook it all the way through until really tender. When it just starts breaking like this, it's cooked. And the infusion, the bread infusion with the milk, just to save a bit of time, because this will take 30, 35 minutes just to be infused properly. You boil the milk, toast your bread, put the bread in the milk, cool it down, put the lid on and leave it like this. And that milk will soak the toastiness of the bread and it will give you a lovely roastiness inside of the sauce. The lemon. Top and the bottom. Take a little shredded knife if you can too, and just follow the lemon. You just go behind the membrane, take the first one, and after you follow the other line, just pull it out, and it's coming out, you see, look. And you get this little segment. One of the elements that's very important in that sauce is the brown butter. And people sometimes got scared to do brown butter because they think, oh, I'm going to burn it, and it's going to be a really bad taste with it. But the butter's got a line from brown to burn. And we want that toastiness inside of that brown butter. Salted butter, if you can. Put it in a pan, but don't be scared to whisk it because the butter milk in the bottom of the pan will catch very quickly, will burn very quickly. Salted butter brings flavor to what you cook. Yeah, that's it. Here you've got the sauce who need to be infused a bit more. It's really in it. The milk has been absorbed by the bread. And you want that to leave it 25 minutes, 30 minutes.
It's just brown.
The more your bread is brown, better it is. It's the same. I'm going to peel the potatoes now. Okay, I'm going to use this pan to caramelize the potatoes.
This is the butter for the potatoes?
Yes.
And it's not brown butter, just regular butter?
Yeah, just to caramelize on brown butter.
Yeah. They're crushed potatoes?
Yes.
Not mashed?
If you do mash after when you come eat with the sauce, everything starts to be sloppy. You want to caramelize these potatoes.
So we're going for a golden brown.
Yes, and you want them to catch in the bottom. And if you look at it, you see this little parchment is the start of the potatoes, really going to give you that lovely flavor. And this can be done. You do it before. Do it in the morning if you want to, at lunchtime, if you got your guests for dinner. We're going to put a bit of brown butter after inside of it.
So browning nicely in the pan.
Yeah, it's very much so.
And then we're ready to strain our milk infusion.
A milk infusion.
Pour that through a sieve, push it through. So
push
you get all of that flavour.
Yeah.
So this is for our vegetarian.
Yes. Now we've got this beautiful mini cauliflower from Waitrose. Uh-huh. Cook them. We're going to blanch them first and roast them after.
And if someone doesn't have the baby cauliflower, could they do this with a larger?
Yes. Cook the cauliflower whole first.
Okay.
And slice it after.
So maybe
a nice steak in it.
Would you roast it whole?
You can, if it depends how many people, but if it's only for two people will eat a medium-sized cauliflower.
Yeah.
You keep the root, don't trim them too long, too short.
Sure.
Because if not, they will break down and put some water in it. Now, you can use a cast iron pan or just a normal one.
Okay.
The cast iron will be perfect when we're going to roast it later on.
Okay, okay.
You keep the...
So not essential.
Okay, the cauliflower, you blanch it for 5-6 minutes. Just really to take... Give it a bit of a start cooking and take any bitterness you will get. Just blanch it with some water.
So not cooked all the way through?
No, not cooked all the way through. Okay. I'm going to drain it now and after we're going to roast it.
And you the potatoes are still on?
Potatoes are still on. See, they're starting getting some colour?
Yeah.
They start caramelising.
We're going, nice browning
we're going to pass them in a bit.
We have browned our butter, ready for the various different things we need it for.
Yeah.
We've infused our milk with our toasted sourdough and then we've strained that through a sieve. And then our potatoes are boiled and peeled and then we crush them lightly. Pop them in the pan with some regular butter, about 50 grams of regular butter. Yeah. And then a splash of brown butter for that extra flavour. And we've still got them on the heat now.
We still want them to caramelise.
Brilliant.
I've got some garnish for the... To put inside of the potatoes when we're going to dress, we've got some dry diced bread. You know, you get some of your brown bread, we're going to show you how to skirt it. Now we've got some capers, where they are salted, but with the vinegar as well, it's very important. Now for the bread, you just dice
it. So thinly sliced and then...
Thinly sliced and just dice it and put them in the oven.
Okay, so cauliflower's blanched, drained.
Yeah. Drain.
And are we just going to roast them?
Now we're going to roast them. Yeah.
Whole.
Whole. Whole with some butter first, and finish it with some brown butter after. In the oven, 180 degrees. Donc the fish we got on a cod fillet. It's been you salted a bit before, just to take the moist from it, to make sure when you're going to steam it, it doesn't break down.
Would you sort of pat it dry a little bit?
Yes,
with
some coarse salt, not fine, coarse salt.
Okay.
Salt it in the morning, leave it dry. I keep the this paper butter at all. Roll it inside of it. Nice way to protect it when you cook it. I put quite a lot of salt in the water in the beginning, so you don't really have to worry about the salt contents.
So we've got
simmer.
The fish in the butter packet.
Yeah.
So could they use a bit of parchment if they haven't
if
got
If they want to, yeah.
Yeah.
I use that because it's easy, it doesn't cost you anything.
Yeah.
And you've got natural fat on it. Okay,
okay
the
great.
Fish is cooking, the cauliflower in the oven.
How long are you looking to roast the cauliflower?
Just until
for?
It's cooked all the way, because keep in mind it's not cooked.
So I suppose the theme here with all of these things is colour. Getting that colour on.
Yeah, a bit of caramelization. You want that butter to really go fast. The cauliflower are cooking, the fish is nearly cooked. You can.
So flaking.
Flaking. If you're not sure, put a knife through it. You pull it out. Put it on your lips. If it's too hot, it's burnt. It's too cooked. You need a little bit more, but you can say like this. You will finish on a natural heat.
And sorry, just quickly going to your sauce there. What's in here now?
Look, here you've got the milk, the brown butter. I'm going to add a bit more lemon.
And in terms of kind of, you've just mentioned there, I suppose, adapting the recipe essentially. Would you suggest anything that you could put in with the infused milk?
Yeah, I mean, we use brown bread, but you can put put some stick of lemongrass in it, lime leaf. We're going to finish the potatoes.
Adjusting with a little bit of sherry vinegar.
This is nearly cooked, I would say another 5 minutes.
And you've got the butter is foaming and it's gone a little bit brown.
That's it.
Any other vegetables that you would go instead of cauliflower?
Any vegetable. Parsley would be great.
Yeah.
We serve sometimes this dish with a poached eggs.
So, potatoes done, cauliflower just finishing off roasting. Our sauce is done. You're happy with the acidity, the seasoning.
Yeah.
Then our fish is just off the heat, but lid on.
Is finishing cooking slowly. It's really
beautiful.
Don't worry about it. If you break, it's fine. It's not. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just the fish is a bit flaky. The cauliflower is cooked.
Beautiful.
So the sauce, you need a hand blender if you've got one at home.
So we're going to emulsify the butter with the milk.
By giving a bit of foam like this, and you get the full flavour. Inside of that sauce is finished normally with some chopped parsley. Don't go too fine, because if not, the herb will come brown. You can use chervil, you can use tarragon if you want to. A flavour with a bit anisey will give you some nice flavour.
Heads up those that are on the vegetarian game tonight, this afternoon.
You know what?
This is your time.
So you've got the caramelised potatoes. Dry brown bread we've done early. Donc this brown bread will give you some texture, some bite. Put some capers, that will give you some acidity.
Finishing it with a little bit more
brown butter. The pulp of the lemon. Do some segment, just dice it and put some of the parsley on top of it. You can put some bread. Outside of the parsley, this is all about decoration more than everything. You put it in the middle.
Look at that.
If you find your sauce doesn't froth like this, that means the sauce is too thick. Just add a bit of milk.
And is it fair to say with all your cooking, it's whole milk, full fat?
Yes.
Go. It's rich, but that acidity just kind of cuts through it all.
Yes. Mm. Sometimes if you taste the potatoes like this, you'll think, oh, I put too much vinegar in it. But keep in mind, when you build a plate, you build a dish, it's never about just one element. It's everything you're going to put in it. Cod one.
So we're just finishing the cod there with
a little bit of brown butter.
Yeah. And you can see from the colour there that you've really taken it just to that point.
Yeah, you take it quite far.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't be shy to take it too far. A bit of parsley, some bread.
I noticed you've been calling them the dried bread. Would you call it croutons?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's croutons, Little segments of lemon, caramelised potatoes. You could put some dry capers just to give you a nice bite. And because at the end, you want that texture. When your fish break like this, take this part of it and put it in the bottom. Put the fish.
Beautiful. It's beautiful. It's so delicious.
Thank you very much.
And that, it kind of, the richness comes through the cod, I think from the butter that,
yes,
that came through it. Claude, thank you so much for joining us.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me this afternoon. It's been an absolute pleasure. I've got two exceptional dishes here in front of me.